My God, am I gonna break this shoe? Go in there. Okay. Oh, it steals me. Nike's introducing its second version of its self-lacing hyper-adapt shoes, the Adapt BB. And this pair is a lot more affordable at $350, pairs over Bluetooth, and remembers how tight you like your shoes. It's a ton of technology packed right under the arch of your foot. People are probably going to buy it in droves just like they do with most any other Nike shoe. But what does it mean when your shoe acts more like a gadget? We wanted to see what they're all about, so we're here today at Nike's campus to try them out. Okay, so these are them. This is a prototype version. This is not the colorway they're gonna be released in, but I've never worn these before. I've never worn the first version either. After all of this hype, this is kind of hard. Okay, that's in. Let's see if I can press some buttons. Oh, now we're tightening. Ooh, it's like giving my foot a hug. Yeah, that is much tighter. Can you guys picture LeBron doing this at the sidelines during a game? Pressing down on his buttons. Although these were neat to try on and unlike any other shoe I've ever worn, I'm not convinced the self-lacing shoes are the future. So I chatted with Nike visionary, longtime designer of the Jordans, and the creator behind the self-lacing shoe concept, Tinker Hatfield.
I was invited into the process of designing products for Back to the Future 2. It just occurred to me, a shoe that would come alive when you touch it, and it recognizes you, essentially adapts to you. Seemed like a very out there futuristic idea, but on the other hand, it also seemed like it would be doable at some point in time.
Power laces, all right.
The Back to the Future shoe was just a prop. There were people controlling the shoe through strings below the floor. Actual self-lacing shoes didn't come out until the Nike Mags in 2016. Then a few months later, the HyperAdapt 1.0s followed. This third version refines everything from those two shoes and gets the HyperAdapt ready for a wide release.
Such a huge amount of effort and engineering that went into this motor, and it's not just the invention of the motor, but then it's how it's been finalized so we can build it for many other people to, you know, use.
This motor is key to making the shoe mainstream. The HyperAdapt 1.0 had tons of cables and wires connecting the laces, motors, and lights. It was a tangled, delicate setup. Compare that to the Adapt BB, where the shoe's technology has been completely re-engineered for mass manufacturing. All the shoe needs to make it smart is its lacing cable and lace engine. The cable is threaded through the motorized spool you see in the lace engine, which then winds around the spool, making the shoe tighter. All the techie stuff is in that engine too, literally everything. Of course, you don't think about any of the tech inside when you're wearing the shoes, but that doesn't change the fact that you're walking on top of a lithium-ion battery and a bunch of other electronics. That's a little scary to me. Jordan Rice, engineer of HyperAdapt, tells me not to worry though, and he walked me through how the team tests the shoes to make sure they won't explode.
So we put it out in the field, we put it on athletes, we've put it on NCAA athletes, semi-pro athletes, athletes that play professionally overseas and come home for the summer, and then regular athletes playing hoops on a Thursday night. We literally beat it up really, really hard right over top of the lace engine in the shoe.
All right, so like vintage HyperAdapt 2.0.
So you mean like 5 years down the line?
Yeah, like 5 years, I wore the hell out of mine, but I'm ready to sell them. Because if the battery's dead, I can't, it doesn't matter about the app support or anything, it's just like I can't tighten the shoes ever again, right?
Yeah, I mean the shoe is dependent on this lace engine. There's not a manual lacing method for it. In terms of battery decay, most of the batteries that you see decay in your normal devices do so because they're being charged and discharged every day. And so you have a certain number of cycles. You go through 365 of those on your phone in a year. It would take you a very long time at 10 to 14 days battery life to go through 365 on these.
Jordan thinks this shoe isn't going to die anytime soon. And anyway, the shoe is smart enough that will always save enough battery to unlace. Worst case scenario though, you can check your battery life through the app and control some other things.
Pair it over Bluetooth and then it'll do a quick tighten, loosen on your feet to sense kind of the optimal setting. Once you have a setting you like, you can also set a mode and save it.
Self-lacing shoes are a really interesting idea that anyone who geeks out on tech or sneakers will probably want to try. Personally, I'm not going to rush out to buy these shoes because I'm not a sneakerhead and I'm not a basketball player. These just aren't the right shoes for me right now. But Nike really seems to believe these are the future.
We've learned how to make shoes a lot better. so they don't stretch as much. But they wanna, everybody wants fresh, new shoes all the time. Our next goal will be to make this in more colors and more styles. If somebody switched shoes, we would like them to, and they would probably like to switch to another shoe that has the same technology in it.
Nike clearly has grander plans for this technology, and you can even see hints of it in the name. Adapt BB stands for Adapt Basketball. So in the future, a different kind of shoe might have a different name, like a running shoe might be Adapt R or something like that. But even if this adaptive fit technology doesn't take off, it's not the end of the world. Nike will go on, and so will laces.
And we'll make sure that there are still cool shoes even 20 years from now that have laces. Mm-hmm. We shake on that?
We'll hold you to it.
Hold me to it if I'm still kicking.
Oh my gosh, dark note to end on.
Oh, dark, yes.
Hey, thanks for going on this self-lacing journey with me. Tell me in the comments, do you want to wirelessly charge your shoes? Do you hate tying your shoes? Let me know. And as always, stay locked to The Verge for all the future tech content you'll ever need.